Down to seven, and we're underway. It's Friday the 6th of July, and we're heading for Orkney. Skipper's on the helm. Nairn is astern. Gold dust to port. Just as a gamely fly in the spinnaker. Oh, I don't think she's getting very much out of it. I'll head up the revs to over 2,000, get us over 5 knots. I'm still wondering whether it should be Helmsdale or Wick. It's a long motor to Wick. Hobart's there. To 8, the sun has broken through, and a minke whale has just pushed right through the fleet, past our starboard, and ahead of Robert's bow, on the stern. Here we are off Helmsdale, and having our afternoon tea. Look at that. Too much! 10-7. There's our neighbour heading for Wick. Beautiful morning. Morning. What a lovely morning. And the Nairn crew are organised too. Robert's getting organised.
Morning.
Good morning. And what a cracker. Eight, and we're well underway. Here we go. What sort of morning is it, Patricia?
It is glorious.
It certainly is. There are our friends. It's gold dust. There's Amrita. We're motoring out of Helmsdale, making our own headwind as there's no wind at all. Up the Caithness coast, which is looking very bonny. Into the sun. Into the rising sun. Look at that. We're doing 5 knots under engine. 9:05. Still no wind. Gold Dust are trying to make something of it with a cruising chute, but no, not enough wind yet. Hopefully, as the sea breeze kicks in, there will be enough wind and we'll get sailing. We're still cruising up the Sutherland coast. 5 to 10, there's a bit more wind now. We have plain sail up, and so does Robert. There he goes. We just passed Dunbeath Castle. In fact, there it is behind Robert. And we're making good progress. We've reduced engine revs and increased speed despite that, because the wind is chugging us along now. And there's gold dust up ahead, flying our cruising chute. Good for them. Look at that. It's the skipper thinking about making tea.
You're worse than me.
I'm trained well. And we're rambling along, Otto's in command. And what a glorious day. Glorious! Gold dust. Wind song, and Amrita. Ten o'clock, so it's time for elevenses. Okay.
Yes.
Oh yes. Here we go.
Like our new table.
Our new table is our cruising chute, which I'm going to launch in a moment as the wind has got up even more. And we'll be able to sail and cut the engine in a moment or two, I think.
Westbound, this is
Goldest. Goldest,
over.
Go ahead, over.
Hiya, David. You're looking rather spectacular there. Looking lovely. Over.
Not any better than you guys. We've cut the engine, we're going to draw a bit of a sail, and it's just great. Wonderful to have the iron jib down. Over.
It certainly is. We've been sailing for quite a while now, but we're doing a 3.5 knots, which is kind of 2.5. I think expected time of arrival is about 1:30 at Wick. Morrison's given the harbour master a wee phone, and he asked us to contact him just before we're ready to come in. Over.
Good for you guys, that's fine. All the organisation is in place, it saves us doing anything. Just great. Great sail until 1:30 or 2 o'clock if the wind persists. And I think it'll actually get up a wee bit once the sea breeze kicks in. So, we're looking good. Over.
Excellent. Happy sailing, we'll see you in a minute.
Wind song out. We've just got the sails up, we've just cut the engine. Amrita, Windsong. Thanks, Robert. Yeah, thought we'd be out beyond them, but no, you're never out beyond them. They're always lurking there and waiting. Oh, I see one to starboard already. Thanks, Robert. Windsong out. We've got the sails up. We've got the engine off. We are sailing. If you look forward, you'll see the sail that's up. What a beauty.
Don't see much of it.
Forward, do you?
No.
You're fit to go forward?
Not going forward.
Skipper's getting narky because she's asked to do a bit of videoing. On the port beam, another of our favourite destinations, Leibster.
We like Leibster.
And here we are coming into Wick. don't know yet. Is that a landing party in there?
Pardon?
Is that a landing party in there, do you think? That's Robert away. What a morning. Morning, guys.
Morning.
Well, you think you're in the mad, eh?
You would, wouldn't you? Indeed. Morris is getting some water. And there's Windsong and Goldust and Wick Harbour. Great showers up there last night. Good facility. When we were coming into Wick yesterday, we saw a vessel leaving a creamy wake behind it. And I said, that must be doing 20 knots. So I looked in the AIS and sure enough, doing 21 knots. And this was it. I had no idea. I thought it might be a Coast Guard cutter, but I have no idea what it is. 9 o'clock, we're leaving Wick Harbour. Lovely morning. We have Mike playing on the radio below, and we're heading out. Off Moss Head. heading for the skerries. And the speed, round about 7 knots. Got the tide, of course, but there's a good beam breeze. And we're romping on. But Paddy's got her seat out, which makes a change. And Goldust is right there. Oh, a bit of a shake there. We'll need to go and adjust the sails. That's if the skipper's on course.
Bang on.
Bang on. Right, I'll need to sheet in a wee bit. 11 o'clock. Here we are, approaching the Sandy Riddle to the east of the Pentland Skerries. And we've just been crossed by a big Smurl Line vessel. There's Goldust hammering on. And we're doing about 7 knots. There we are, crossing the Sandy Riddle under full plain sail. Not quite close hauled, close reaching, but we'll be close hauled soon to make up to Orkney. There's Goldust romping on behind. Quarter to 12, we crossed the riddle. We've shortened sail and we're heading up close hauled, get as close to Orkney as we can. We're not making quite the course we would like to, but it's not bad. We're making up there towards the Horse of Copensay. And then it'll be a short tack in from there. Top carrier crossing our bows there. Oh, there's Goldust romping on behind us. 1 o'clock and we've just finished a hot meal. The skipper was below on the cooker and produced a hot meal. Sausages and veggie sauce. Delicious. We're crashing on and we're down to about 5 knots now. But still making a better heading of it. We're getting inside the Horse of Copensay, well inside just now. It's over there. Oh, I've lost it, can't see it. There it is. Horse of Copensay and the horse behind it. So we're here as we were, we're sailing outside it. We're now sailing well inside, we've got a great lift. And we're crashing on. Windsong sailing herself hour after hour to windward. No autopilot and nobody to touch the helm. On she goes. And as I say, it's about 5 knots. We're cruising, we're not racing. And the Goldusters are crashing on as well. If I could hold this a bit more steadily, and then you'll see them. Ooh. Well done, you guys. 25 to 2. And we're getting into the sheltered lee of the Orkney Islands. The waves are down considerably. And we're approaching our destination, Home Sound. Another only about 4 miles away, but perhaps 7 miles sailing because we'll have to tack since we're hard on the wind here. 5 knots. Great sailing. Home Sound's been sailing herself for hours. No hand in the helm. 5 past 3, and here we come into Home Sound. That's Roseness Lighthouse. We're just not quite making into the sound, but we're beating up towards it. And there's Gold Dust. Look at that. We've dropped anchor in East Weddell Sound, and here's Gold Dust going to do the same thing. Away in, Skipper spotted lobster pots or lobster markers, one tiny cork marker with miles and miles of string on the surface. Not only that, but a whole row of them as if in a barrier across the sound. Very dodgy. There they go. 9:30. We're exiting Home Sound. We're out of Weddell Sound. Didn't have such a problem with boys on the way out as we had on the way in. Morris reckoned that the guy collected them this morning in a little work boat. Here come the dusters. Roseness Lighthouse on the port bow. We're about to head up a little bit in behind Copensay over the shallows and the roost, which will be almost nothing at the moment, and hence on up to the String and Kirkwall. We've got the engine running and all plain sail set. There's hardly any wind. We had drizzle this morning, which is disappointing, but it's rather nice now.
Not much wind.
Not much wind, no. 9:45. And we're off Roseness. We're about to head up inside Copensay. Think the dusters are sailing, not motoring. They've dropped the stern a bit. But they'll soon turn on the donkey and catch up. Rounded Roseness and turned north. Little fishing boat in against the coast. We're heading what Copham's here. The destinations are in a fantastic city. Here we are, heading for the Pass of Copensea, where it's quite shallow. 3 metres at its lowest. And there's usually a bit of a roost as we go through. 11, that's the Pass of Copensea. These are the testers. And the skipper's below making tea for the crew. 10:50. Here we are bowling along off Dearness, hard on the wind. Not quite making our course, alas. The skipper has just given us our tea. And here's gold dust off Copensea. Romping north in the Orkneys. There's the Horse of Copensea. And Copensea itself. The gold dusters. Under 12 knots, 11 knots of wind, and we're beating hard to windward. We're at Deer Sound abeam. Hope we stay behind. And the gold duster is right astern. 12:46. And we're cross-tacking up towards the stream. There she goes. Here we are in the string, passing Chapensea Lighthouse. Chapensea Castles, off to the left there, slightly forward. We're down a bit so we've got full sail up. And behind us are the dusters. Well, we've just freed off around Thieves Home into Kirkwall Bay, or heading into Kirkwall Bay. And there's the dusters, with Chapensea Lighthouse behind them. Well done, guys. Zonking on. 23 on Tuesday, we've just been on a bus trip out to Skara Brae and the Ring of Brodgar. And we're now getting on deck to go into the town to the bakery. And who's joined us? But a little guillemot. There's a nice little display for us.
Left Kirkwall behind. Hazy morning. At least it's not raining as it was forecast.
Oh, it's 10:20 and we've left Kirkwall. We're motoring because the wind's on the nose. We're hoping to get out into Gairsley Sound about the turn of the tide at 11, and then we're going to romp down Ain Hollow with the start of the ebb. Hopefully to pass the roost at Ain Hollow before the maximum ebb. and then on down to Stromness. The dusters are quite a bit ahead of us, heading out into Guernsey Sound at the moment. And all is well. We're going out through here, inside Seal Skerry.
Quarter to 12. That's Einhollow Island behind us. It's gold dust, and we've just had a very, very brief flurry from dolphins. We came through the roost at Einhollow, pulled into the island to keep out of the worst of it, and had a wee bump as we went through. Oh, the dolphins are still hereabouts. Deep down there. +12, we've just borne away round Hoff's Helia, I think it's called. We've got the sails up, although there's very little wind. We're managing some motor sailing. The gold dust is romping along there, enjoying it. To one, and we've just passed Broch Head, and we're bearing away even further down the west coast of mainland Orkney. And gold dust is just crossing our stern, so we can get a little view of him with Broch Head behind, or Broch Head, or Bro Head, or whatever it is we will have to discover. Kitchener's Gold Dust off Kitchener's Memorial Monument. Flying our way down the west coast of Orkney. Coming into Stromness. Just about to round up in. Grimsey to starboard. Here are the dusters. Plus four, skipper's conning us into Stromness. There's Goldust heading up into the wake of that boat going out. And coming in by Grimsey Light. Grimsey Light astern. Here she comes. Fuel berth in Stromness Marina. We've had our fuel. We're not bothering moving because we're going away after lunch. We're meeting the guys for lunch at 1:30 and we're heading for the museum just now to see if there's anything we can go to in Scapa en route to Long Hope this afternoon. This is Stromness Marina. Owen's boat there, magician. We haven't seen him. We have bumped into Willie Finney several times already, and his boat is out there. Serena, Antiserina, as we've heard her called on the VHF. Stromness has dozens of little venals leading down to the sea and gardens that end in the sea beautifully, but this is one that we particularly like, this little house here. It's a cracker, and there's its garden going down to the sea. Isn't it quaint? And here's the other side. Isn't it great?
Not the best road to live on, we think.
We like the flagged streets and Venels. This is the main street actually. The Venels go off to your left down to the sea. Another little Venel. And another Venel. And another. And another. We've had our lunch, discussed our plans. Heading back to the boat. See Guillemot. And an eider duck. On Thursday the 12th, and we're leaving Stromness. And here's Goldust coming out with a ferry behind her. We're heading into Scapa. We've got full plain sail, and there's enough wind to sail by. Hooray! Here's Goldust ghosting past Grimsey Lighthouse. Almost no wind, but we're making headway. And that's good enough for us. Herding cormorants at the moment. All swimming frantically ahead. Here we are motoring into Long Hope. We've sailed the whole way and just started the motor a couple of minutes ago. Both Goldust and ourselves sailed the whole way in very, very light winds. It's a lovely sail. It's even lovelier now, the sun's come out. Alas, one of the two mooring boys is occupied. So just had a confab with Goldust, and they've kindly offered to do the anchoring since they've got a young crew and more of them. So we're going to get the mooring boy, thank you Goldust, and they're going to anchor. It's one glorious evening. There's Long Hope, and the sun's come out. The sun's just come out. Not a breath of wind now. Here we are, motoring into Long Hope, which looks absolutely idyllic. Hear the bow chuckling through the water. And all is well. that's where we're headed. Doesn't look like there's a strop on it. And there we are, tucked away in Long Hope. Gold Dust have anchored right ahead. And it is one glorious evening. We're going to eat in the cockpit. And look at it. Magic. Look at that nice bit of brickwork, nice private jetty there. There's a ferry line alongside Long Hope Pier.
Quarter past eight. Good time snack. At 4:30 tomorrow morning.
To cross the Pentland in spring tides. Ten past nine in the evening at Long Hope. How beautiful is that? That is stunning. Beautiful. It's 9:45. The sun has just set over the hill, and it's time for bed. Look at that. You beauty. 5:40 in Long Hope, and the sun rises. Oh my. That is glorious. Oyster catchers are tweeting. Gold Dust is lying serene. Voices are floating over from the pier. can easily see why ancient man worshipped the sun. No sooner had I exulted in the wonderful morning than the fog rolled in. There's the dusters raising their hook. Slow down, just haven't got it raised yet. Ah, yeah, there's the hook breaking the surface. And look what's happened. Oh! Nil visibility. So we're going to potter down to the head of the sound and see what it's like just beyond. Hope it's better than this. There we go. Look at this. Ridiculous. Here are the dusters. Our temerity has paid off. Here we are. We've broken through the mist. Visibility is good again. And we're heading out into the Pentland. Skipper's just increased the revs. We're doing over 4 knots and feeling a wee swirl of tide. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Ten to six. We're approaching Cantick Head. And we can see Duncan's Bay. And we're going to sweep between Smona and Stroma. And then we're going to sweep east on the roller coaster down by Wick to Leicester. And what a beautiful morning again. The morning has redeemed itself. Look at that. Cantick Head abeam. Smona ahead. We're pointing at it but not heading for it. We're heading more towards Stroma. And we've left the Orkneys, or we're leaving the Orkneys. Past six on a glorious morning, and there's gold dust leaving the Orkneys into the flood in the Pentland Firth. A There's a lot of localised fog in the Orkneys. Five to seven. And here we are with Stroma Abeam already. Here's Stroma. And there's Goldust. And behind Stroma is Dunnet Head. Dunnet Head and Swilkie Point in transit. And Goldust almost in transit. Goldust with Orkney behind her. Orkney still shrouded in mist a bit. Swilkie Point on Stroma. And Goldust got Torness Head behind her. With Brown S, South Ronaldsay behind her. What sort of picture is that then? Past seven. And there's Goldust with the Pentland Skerries behind. And the rising sun behind. And what a glorious sight. We're romping on again now, over 7 knots. Just picking up the flood. And the flood will romp us down the coast of Sutherland. Cracking on, over 8 knots.
Current signal gale 1, I'm enforced at this time.
Lankinsby Head.
Weather control forecast for Shetland waters, covering a 60 nautical mile radius from Lilac. It will be there 12 hours from 0600 on Friday, 30th July. General situation for Shetland.
Stroma.
A ridge extending north across Shetland and Inverness, which passes east today as the mountain trough
and Orkney.
Northwesterly 3 or 4 at first in east, and southwesterly 3 or 4 at
first. Goldust.
Otherwise,
and the Pentland Skerries behind.
Slight but smooth in Shetland east, mainly fair, good. An outlook for 12 hours from 1800 on Friday. Variable 3 or less at first in east. Otherwise, southerly 4 or 5. Occasionally 6 later in north. Slight occasionally moderate in northwest. that's smooth is traveling east. Mainly fair, but patchy rain later and far west. Good, occasionally moderate later and far west.
Plus 7. Just coming by Duncansby Head. And what do we see to the right of the lighthouse? It's the ubiquitous camper vans, a row of them. That's some position though. No wonder they're there, eh? And gold dust with Orkney behind her. And sweeping west. Stroma. Dunnet Head, Duncansby Head, and sweeping south, Moss Head. What a glorious day! What a glorious day! Big loneliness, lots of sea life. A group of guillemots. O'clock, the sun is still shining as you can see, and here we are off Noss Head. Nest just north of Leibster Ravine. We're thinking now of going on to Helmsdale instead of into Leibster. It's rather early to go into Leibster. And here come the dusters, just approaching Clyth Ness. We got in at 2 o'clock, chewing the fat there, and we're lying alongside Amity. So it was a very good run. Long hope to Helmsdale, 5 o'clock to 2 o'clock, 9 hours. Saturday morning, and a moment ago we were high and dry and at a slightly jaunty angle. I think we've levelled up now. Yeah, I think we're floating again. and Helmsdale look serene this morning. Very pretty house just right behind me, right at the pierhead. There you go. That's a cracker. Just going to take a walk out the pier and have a look at the channel. And that's Helmsdale River. There's the remains of a winch, rather artistic looking, at the head of the pier.
10:10, we've left Helmsdale, and here I am enjoying motoring. We've got the tide under us, heading up to Little Ferry. About 15 miles, 3 hours to Little Ferry. We'll go in on a rising tide. But I'm really enjoying the motoring. She's pumping into it beautifully.
So it's farewell Helmsdale. And Little Ferry, here we come. We're bouncing along, engine purring sweetly. And the dusters are right behind.
Quarter past 11, we've had a change of plans. We've decided to sail up to Port Mahomock rather than motor up to Little Ferry. So we're going to enjoy a sail and arrive a bit later, and instead of Little Ferry here, we're going to Port Mahomock in here. And we've got the sails up and we've got some wind out here, so Windsong is sailing herself to windward 5.5-6 knots. No auto helm, she just sails herself to windward. And the skipper's below making tea for the crew. It's 20:1, we got a bit more wind at last. We're beginning to move. Beginning to get going. We've shortened sail. And we're getting going. Windsong is sailing herself again to windward. We're making a bit more of it now. We have 25 knots or more.
Then we got more wind than we bargained for. 36 knots and short, steep waves to go with it. It's slow.
slow this down dramatically.
Anchor now for about an hour, and Paddy, we're off Port Mahomock. The Dusters thought it was a bit uncomfortable at Port Mahomock, so they came up here and found this quieter anchorage. There they are. We're just off Inver Bay, in fact, and the wind blowing off the land. All is well, nice and comfortable. There's the port. Tomorrow, we're heading for Cromarty. But we could easily drop into Balty en route. The tides are right for it, the times are right. So that's what we may do. I've lowered the dinghy and put a little bit of air in it, ready to row up to Gold Dust, because we're having an evening of games with them. Sailing game, sailing quiz game, I think. So that should be fun. And we're rowing up into the wind, so I'll be wind assisted on the way back.
9, we've just had our tea and toast.
We're lying in Inver Bay, just south of Port Mahomock, at the mouth of the Dornoch Firth.
Southwest of Port Mahomock, actually.
There's Gold Dust. We were there last night, having a convivial evening of chat and games. And there's Port Mahomock. Of Sutherland on the Dornoch Firth. Here's Windsong passing Port Mahomock. Here's Gold Dust passing Port Mahomock. Of Sutherland behind. There's gold dust just off the port beam. Rounding Tarbet Ness. Someone's built a quaint little summer house. Down on the shore there, a little path running down to it. And they're in residence at the moment. Just passing Balone Castle. Now approaching Brockfield. Clock. It's Rockfield abeam. Here we are off Hilton. And Ballantore Harbour ahead in the rain. Alas, the rain has come on. Here we are in Bolty. I didn't notice. There's Goldust with a massive wind farm transport vessel behind her. She's seen everything these holidays. Here we are coming in at the North Souter, coming in about 7 to 9 meters and therefore keeping out of the worst of the ebb. Actually, we've picked up speed in here, so we must be getting a wee contrary eddy, or at least the ebb is abated. I love these cliffs. Here we are in Cromarty. We've been ashore to the baker's, as you can see. It's a lovely calm day, as you can see. There was a bit of a breeze earlier on. I thought we were going to get a good sail across, but it's now very quiet. Here's the ferry coming in. We've got a slight roll on. Must be a wake of a boat going past. Cromarty's as lovely as ever. The gardens are beautiful. And Robert was here waiting to welcome us when we got in yesterday. There's Amrita. And we were on board there last night for a blether. And Robert has just been picked up and he's gone on to Goldust for his morning tea. We'll be tidying up and getting underway quite soon. The new dinghy has served very nicely with the outboard. More than enough power and just a little bit more spacious, just very comfortable indeed. Tricia's delighted with it.
Mm-hmm.
Big improvement. So there we are, Cromarty, and soon to depart for Nairn, the final leg. 10 past 12, skipper's watching the depth carefully as we're hugging the shallows to keep out of the tide here. As we exit the Souters and say farewell to Cromarty. How's the depth now?
3.2.
3.2, that's excellent. That's where we want to be, in the shallows, out in the tide. The fleet has departed. There's Amrita, Robert soloing. Visitors. And gold dust. With some wind farm equipment behind her. At Nick. We've just lost the wind completely. We had been sailing a little bit, well, motor sailing. But now we're motoring again. And Nairn is fast approaching. There's Robert enjoying his sail. We've just had our tea. And there are the dusters. Our cruising chute has been much in evidence coming across the Murray Firth. Five past two, and there's the dusters completing their Orkney voyage. As are we.